Hello. In this session, I would like to illustrate how one implements callable flows between IBM App Connect Enterprise on the cloud and App Connect Enterprise on premises. And I'll be specifically looking at the case where App Connect Enterprise is implemented in IBM Cloud Pak for integration, CP4I. I'm showing on the screen here the Knowledge Center from IBM for IBM App Connect Enterprise software, specifically at the callable message flow section, which has a lot of information, but particularly includes this diagram you can see here, which illustrates the scenario I'll be setting up. So as the wording says immediately below, if your flows are split between ACE and App Connect on the cloud, the switch server is managed by App Connect in the cloud. That's the most important bit, really, at the beginning, is to emphasize that the switch server is implemented free of charge by IBM for you in IBM Cloud. In this particular case, my application running in the cloud is going to be invoking the callable flow with the callable flow invoke, and my callable flow itself will be implemented on premises, as I say, within Cloud Pak for integration. And as it says in the wording just immediately down below here, you download a file from the cloud that configures the connectivity agent. So here we notice the agent configuration file is downloaded from the cloud and used to configure on premises. And the extra bit of information that is not immediately obvious, which this video will demonstrate, is how to implement the agent configuration file within Cloud Pak for integration. The first thing I need to do is to sign onto IBM Cloud to get to my App Connect software as a service in IBM Cloud to download the agent configuration file. So I'll sign on. I've now signed on to IBM Cloud and I can see all my services, and the one I want happens to be this one, App Connect in IBM Cloud. So I'll click it to select it. This takes me to this screen here, which is my App Connect at IBM Cloud. I happen to have a server deployed, but we're not interested in that. What is important, however, is my list of callable flows. This shows for the switch server that comes as part of the service, part of IBM App Connect SaaS in IBM Cloud. This shows me what callable flows the switch server is aware of. And because I haven't configured anything yet, it's not aware of any callable flows yet. I'll be doing that for the rest of this video. So the first thing I'll do is make sure I download the agent configuration file that I talked about earlier. And in order to do that, I select to connect callable flows and download the configuration. That downloads this file called agentx.json, which is the configuration file that defines for a client of the switch server how to access the switch server in order to register the callable flows that are available. There are instructions on the screen here about how to install and update the agent if you're running App Connect Enterprise on-premise in a traditional software manner, but we're not doing that. We're implementing App Connect Enterprise in Cloud Pak for integration, in which case these instructions do not apply, and I'll be going through that shortly. That's all I need to do here. So having connected callable flows and having downloaded the agentx.json file, I'll move on now to Cloud Pak for integration. Jumping back to my picture, I'll just illustrate what I've done. I've taken this agent configuration file and I've simply downloaded it onto my workstation at the moment. So it's sitting waiting for me to use. I've also signed on to IBM App Connect Enterprise on cloud. And the switch server is there. There's nothing really to see apart from that list of callable flows, but the switch server is there available. Now what I'll do is I'll show you the integration flow that's running on-premise, but it isn't really on-premise, remember. It's in Cloud Pak for integration, which of course doesn't have to be on-premise. And I'll illustrate how to deploy this flow and attach the relevant agent file to it. I've now signed on to Cloud Pak for integration and gone to the Cloud Pak for Integration Navigator, which you can see in front of you now. And what I'm going to do is configure within the App Connect dashboard. So I click that one, which takes me through to a screen that lists a number of integrations and servers. You can deploy an integration, a bar file, to create an integration server. And at the time of doing that, create the agent configuration file that is required to speak to the switch server. What I'm going to do, however, is set that up beforehand using the configuration button there. At the moment, I can see the types are listed in type order. There are no agentx files configured already. a whole bunch of other files available, but no agent X files. So I'm going to create a configuration. And at this point, I specify an agent X file. I've given it the name agent file for connection to switch server. I've given it a nice useful description. It's important to emphasize the point. This is an outbound connection from CP4I to the switch server. It's an outbound connection, so you don't have any connection required from the cloud into CP4I. It's an outbound connection from CP4I. And at this point, in a manual method, all I need to do is select the agent file or click to upload it into here. I shall now do that. That file is now available. The configuration is now going to be stored as a secret. This agentx.json file is not going to be visible anymore. You can view it from this point here, and you can see there is the information. But once I create it, it is not visible. I've created that configuration. You can now see that the agentx file is available there. At this point, I can go and look at it. I can update it, certainly, give it a new description, for example. But the contents are redacted. I can't go and view them. So it is secure. This agent X configuration can now be used when I want to deploy my bar file. If I now jump to my ACE toolkit, you can see this in front of you here. And this is the callable flow that I have created. It starts with a callable input and it ends with a callable reply. And the most important point is the name on the callable input, the endpoint name. You can see here is initiate complex processing. Inside this flow, you can do any number of things, and it's beyond the scope of this video to go into the detail of that. The name is the important thing here. So I'm now going to package this up as a bar file using standard ACE techniques and then deploy the bar file to the CP4I. Here I am within the ACE toolkit. I've created a bar file. I have selected all the relevant elements I want to include in it. I shall build and save the bar file. Having built and saved the bar file, I can use it locally to my local integration nodes to test it out. What I shall do, however, is export that bar file to the file system so I can then import it into my target CP4I. Back in Cloud Pak for integration, I was looking at my configurations within the App Connect dashboard. Let's get back to the dashboard itself. There are a few different ways of configuring, deploying an integration server. I'm going to use the most simple now, which is to create the server and specify the bar file to be imported at that time. So I'm specifying to create a server. It's a toolkit integration I'm going to create, not a designer integration. And at this point here, I can now select the bar file I've just created. There is my bar file. I can select that to be imported into the asset registry within App Connect in CP4I. Having specified that, this is now the point at which I make my callable flow connection. This is the point at which I specify as a configuration to go with this bar file to be part of the integration server, the name of the configuration, the agent X configuration that you saw me creating just a few minutes ago. And that's basically the main requirement to match the two together. At this point, I can say, carry on, give it a name. There are obviously a bunch of settings I could set at this point. For this very basic configuration, I'm going to specify create now, and off it goes and starts to implement my integration server. It will remain unavailable for a few minutes. On this particular environment, it typically takes between 3 and 4 minutes before it becomes initially available. Back in my IBM App Connect in the cloud dashboard on the callable flows tab, I can see no callable flows yet. I press F5 to refresh. This is while the integration server is being deployed in the background. As I say, it could take a few minutes to be deployed. I press F5 occasionally and we should see the callable flow appear on this screen here in just a moment. And there it is. There is my callable flow, which has now finished building on CP4I, has registered itself using the agent X file with the switch server up in App Connect Cloud. And you can see its details there. You can see the application name and, most importantly, the endpoint name that I defined earlier, and also a bit of information about where it's deployed. The name integration underlying server is provided automatically by CP4I, and there's the name that I provided it when I created it. Incidentally, if I jump back to my App Connect dashboard, you can see the bar file that I deployed, the integration server that I started to create earlier, has now been fully started and is completely available and is green. I've just jumped back to the picture to illustrate what I've done. I've now deployed the callable flow within an integration server inside Cloud Pak for integration, which on this diagram is shown as on-premises. And importantly, I have, of course, attached the agentx.json agent configuration file to it. I'll now go to the App Connect Enterprise on the cloud and show very briefly how to configure an application to invoke that callable flow. So back in IBM App Connect in the cloud, I was on the callable flows tab, as you can see here, and there is my callable flow. If I jump back to the home, I'm going to create a flow which then uses the callable flow. It doesn't matter how I start the flow. I'll happen to use the arrival of a new email. That isn't important to the illustration I'm going to do, which is to select what happens after the emails arrive. And at this point, I can select which application to add, and it's going to be a callable flow. And the important point here is that when I add the invoke, the system knows, IBM App Connect knows, that there is a callable flow in an application called CP4I Work, which you saw earlier. And if I select that, it then shows for me the available endpoints. There is only one endpoint at the moment, initiate complex processing. And that's essentially it. There's nothing more that is required. I could start the flow. The email would arrive and the callable flow would be invoked. Obviously, typically, I need to do some mapping. For example, I really ought to pass the callable flow some message data, and possibly I could select some values to put in the local environment variables. The details of what goes into a callable flow are outside the scope of this particular session. So finally, looking at the picture, I'll just close off this session by confirming what the last bit I've done here, which was to go to IBM App Connect Enterprise on the cloud and create an application to invoke the callable flow I just created. Because I was creating that integration on the cloud, it already knew about the switch server because the switch server is also on the cloud. So having created the application there, it now has access to the callable flow. I do hope this has proved useful to you. Thank you very much indeed for watching.